Hello. Me again. So, after my last video, I discovered another problem and kind of started looking at the what I'm going to call resonant frequency crossover. Now, keep in mind, I have a Rat Rig 300 with IDEX. So this is IDEX, not hybrid. And in IDEX mode, these belts at the bottom here have these lower belts are one belt per tool head. So this top belt is T0, this bottom belt is T1, and then but this is for X only, and then the top belt here is for Y only. So this is the right Y, from this motor stack. And by resonant frequency crossover, what I'm talking about is the vibrations from these belts, will transmit up this bearing stack, into your Y belt. So this is why it's important to deal with your understand. So this is why it's important to understand your input shaper graphs and what they're telling you, and how to potentially deal with those, deal with that and fix that. So in my particular case, I have a, my bottom belts here, on my X, I have a resonant frequency of about 50 Hertz. That you can see right here, X is red and my Y is, green. So I have this little bump on my input shaper at roughly 65 Hertz. And, why is that? So with IDEX, if I'm doing the shaper graph for X, only, one of these belts is moving. In this particular case, this is T0. So this top belt is the only belt that's vibrating. And what this is saying is that when I'm vibrating on the X-axis, as my resonant frequency gets to 50, I get the most movement along my X-axis. And then as it starts decreasing, it hits a second peak here. It hits this kind of second peak that causes vibration along the Y-axis. And that is what I'm talking about. So as my x-axis increases, it starts vibrating. At 50 Hertz, there's really not any big deal. But once it gets closer to 65 Hertz, the vibration is going down. But as it gets closer to 65 Hertz, that is causing it to resonate on the Y belt because it's getting transmitted up this stack. So as the X axis vibration is going down, it gets closer to 65, which is increasing my Y axis vibration. And that you can actually clearly see here as the resonant frequency starts going down, the motion along the Y axis starts increasing until it hits the peak at 65. And we can actually kind of pretty clearly see that over here, if we look at the input shaper along the y-axis, we've got a very nice, you know, peak here from the Y, and then another peak here on X, and a similar thing. Now, why there's not a bigger peak on the X axis is very simply put, with this belt pathing for the Rat Rig V4, when you're moving Y, all four belts, including the right belt and left, or sorry, the left belt, this is the right belt, all four belts are involved in the Y-axis movement. Whereas in an X-axis movement, only one belt is involved in that with this belt pathing. So there's not really any great cancellation effects going on your X-axis, which is why you get such a clean double spike here when your belts resonate at different frequencies on X versus Y. There are a couple ways that I'm going to try to fix this. My belts are all tensioned the same, and they're all the same length from bearing to bearing. But if we look at the bearing stacks here, we have two different lengths of belts here. We've got this back belt here, which goes to this bearing, and then this front belt here, which goes to this bearing. So T0 only has this one length on this side here, which matches up with this length. It does not have anything that matches with this length. So we can get into a weird situation where the vibration on this motor shaft gets transmitted up and can cause this to shake. So what I'm going to try to do, there's two approaches that I'm going to try. First off, I'm going to try to change the length of my Y belt. So my Y belt at the tensioner block, I'm going to try shortening it or even actually lengthening this, which is going to cause this bearing to go this way, make the belt shorter, or go this to the left to make it longer. And that will change my resonant frequency at the same tension. The idea is that hopefully I can either get these two frequencies to line up and kind of meet in the center. So decrease my Y resonant frequency, increase my X resonant frequency. Or the other option is to separate these resonant frequencies more, is to move this down, the x-axis down resonant frequency and the y-axis up on the resonant frequency. Because ideally, if there's less shaking, and this is just kind of my thought, is if there's less resonant frequency or the magnitude of amplitude of the resonant frequency is less, like here, down here, it's going to cause less of a spike on Y and be less of a problem if I can actually separate those. So if I can actually move this Y spike this way, down to here, there's less vibration coming from the actual X-axis. So this spike will be hopefully much less pronounced and we'll see a much smaller spike, which will impact the print hopefully less. So those are the two things that I'm going to try. I've already tried tightening this, these bolts down more. I've tried tightening them less. I've tried shifting them a little bit. Tried twisting this and skewing that right or left to try to get a better result. Basically, that's not happening. So none of those actually impacted and improved the results. So it really comes down to these resonant frequencies being tension related. So the belt tension related. And the actual belt length. I know these belts are tensioned highly similar to each other. I've used the belter multiple times. I've also used the guitar tuning application multiple times. I've tried a bunch of stuff, and ultimately they're, the tension is, I'm pretty certain that my tension is fine. And identical on both of these belts. It's just that they are vibrating at slightly different frequencies. So that's my plan, is I'm going to try playing with the belt length a little bit to try to shift these two resonant frequencies to be closer to each other. So good luck. Have fun, folks. And hopefully you have better input shaper graphs than I do.